check the... Yep, it's recording the audio. Okay, just double checking because last time we forgot, I forgot to check. And part of it did not work. Right. Well, the record is on, so I'm gonna get the class started. I could not print this morning. Somebody changed the setup on the printer, so I have to match the change accordingly, but I haven't got the time to do it yet. So I'm gonna pass the row sheet from last week and just add a new row. I'm gonna do that. I'll just add a new column, and you just have to initial in the new column, okay? So 9-6 is a new column. Just try your best to line up on the rows, because I know it's a little bit harder, without the grid lines. Just a little. There you go. All right. So are there any questions about the homework assignment? Yes.
So I'm doing you're showing us on the board how to do it. You said that we would not be using subcircuits, but the
you won't be using subcircuits. You'll be using a 2-bit adder as a subcircuit.
Okay, so create the 2-bit adder just on one level, turn it into a circuit, and then use that to create
a 4-bit adder.
Okay.
Yep.
Do we end up with an extra OR for the carry?
Yes. We just need 3 ORs.
No, there should not be an extra. Okay, what if an extra? Extra two on the outside of the 2-bit adder? Is that what you mean?
No, within the 2-bit adder, when you carry from the first bit to the second bit,
you don't need it. You can skip it. You can just reroute all of those wires straight to the second bit. They carry over.
Okay, your 2-bit adder has 3 inputs. And it has 5 inputs and 3 outputs. Okay, so the 5, I described it incorrectly in response to one of your questions, because I told one person there are only 3 bits to the input. No, there are actually 5 bits to the input. Okay, so let me see if I can do this part using VLC and my document camera. It's just a little bit more freeform, I think it's easier.